Hey guys, this is Nikhil and you're listening to a podcast which is on experimental basis, and we're going to be doing a topic called Rethinking Marketing from Harvard Business Review of Strategic Management. This book is written by three geniuses, and this book is basically focused on what's happening on strategic management and how we as a people need to pursue this. And here with me is my research associate. We're going to be having a conversation on major information that's happening here. Hi, buddy.
Hi, Nikhil.
So let's start all the way from the top. What do you think about the term marketing?
Marketing, I think it's the innovation and creativity. How well do you know your customers and how well do you sell your products?
Well, that is a well-put definition in the modern perspective, but let me tell you a timeline of marketing and a very bird-eyes perspective. Mm-hmm. Marketing as itself started long back, around 120 years back, around 1900s. Mm-hmm. And this actually affected through, like, one of the major way marketing was affected through was mass printing, which happened in around 1450s. Later, due to mass printing, there were billboards. Later, around 1800s, there was Industrial Revolution. Due to surplus products by a lot of companies, they are selling their products to new territories. A brand which is not known for a new territory, people need to advertise it, people need to let know that a brand like this exists. Trust need to be built up, and the marketing was exactly what it was doing. It was trying to accumulate the information and try to build up trust and try to sell products like goods and services. And later, around 1920s, radio advertisement started. Later in 1940s, television commercial started, and the first aired commercial was during New York Yankees, baseball game by a watch company. Later on 1970s, telemarketing and magazine marketing happened, and 2000 internet marketing started, and around 2003 the age of inbound marketing started. Customization, understanding patterns, value for customer retention, live data. And now after 2012 there is a social media boom that happened, influential marketing, and a lot of interesting stuff what we're going to be discussing today. So what do you think about the term rethink marketing?
According to Nikhil, what timeline you have shared with us, it is the change of the communication channel according to the technology and demand in the market of consumers, what I think.
Well put. And I think in the present scenario, the way how people consume information or a set of idea need to be developed and need to be understood, a trust need to be built before taking a decision on purchase capacity. If something is going above his purchase capacity, the more the information is, the better for them to take a decision. And this process slowly started changing to an extent where rather than it's seller's market, now it's a buyer's market.
As you mentioned that the marketing perspective and channels have changed, what do you think in a company like B2C marketing officers and all, right now as a company, if they want to market the product into the market, what priorities they have while choosing the strategy or communication plan?
Okay, for this question I have an example which is also mentioned in the book. IBM was a company which was very massive during its time in 1970s. They used to be working on product development manager, someone who is very well expert on what exactly they are selling. And later, after understanding the consumer value and consumer retention, maintaining a lifetime value with consumers, they started changing their job descriptions of a product development manager towards consumer manager, someone who is good not just on product but also consumer. So this created an opportunity for this particular brand. Let's give an example. IBM is selling a particular product, and let's say they are selling electronic machine which is used for computing. So they have all the technical knowledge that is needed to sell this particular data processing unit. But now at this moment, not just they know about their product but they also know about consumers. So they know, product managers also know what exactly rate they need to sell this product for, what do people think about the brand, and according to their consumer data, they can even interpret and predict that if I as IBM can sell extra products, like if I can sell CPU with that, I can sell monitors with that, I can sell mouse, I can sell a lot of extra goods and services which I'm going to be producing with this main product which I'm going to be selling, just because I know exactly what consumer thinks about.
So, Nikhil, are you trying to say that IBM as a company, they replaced the job description from a marketing manager to a consumer manager?
Yes, at some point that is true. Just to a given perspective, there is this comparison between how old a new VESA developed. Previously, it was to be a product profitability. Now it changed to consumer profitability. Previously, it used to be current sales. Now it used to be consumer lifetime. And previously, it used to be brand equity. Now it is consumer equity. Previously, it used to be market share. And now it is consumer equity share. This actually gives a wider perspective that people are more thinking about consumer. What it happens is any major company, let's say Amazon, Facebook, any such billion-dollar company right now exists in market. The reason they are famous is not just because of the product, but also the data accumulated all the years they were using. So they have a clear idea about what kind of consumers they have. That is the reason when they release a new product, most possible that product might be a success because the company not just know about themselves, they also know their audience. I think that is something we can call as rethink marketing. And to give a perspective to a top level management, how they're changing. After CEO, they used to be chief marketing officer, which right now became to chief consumer officer. There are softwares like CRM, there are softwares like NLP, like natural language processing, and other softwares which were used very specifically to understand how people are perceiving information and converting into big data, which will be later used again on consumers to understand their buying patterns. So that's it for today. That's an overview which we try to cover as much as possible during our conversation. And this is purely on research purpose. We don't write any copyright information. And this is a contribution towards our research project. And please do give us valuable suggestions and feedback regarding the same.